Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This video is part 3 in the STM32 Custom Bootloader series, where we continue building on what we have learned so far. In the previous videos of this series, we saw how to divide the flash memory between the bootloader and the application. We also learned how the bootloader performs basic application validation by checking a magic number before making a jump to the application. As per the schedule, today we will implement a strict application validation process before the bootloader is allowed to jump to the application. This makes the system safer and more reliable. This validation will include checking the application size, sanity, and also the most important check, CRC verification, which helps detect corrupted firmware. The application will calculate and store its CRC value inside the application header during build time. The bootloader will then calculate the CRC on its own and compare it with the CRC value stored in the application header. If both CRC values match, the bootloader will validate the application and safely jump to it. If the values do not match, the jump will be rejected. The components used in this project are still the same as in the previous videos, so there are no hardware changes. A red LED blinking will indicate that the bootloader failed to jump to the application, while a green LED blinking will indicate a successful jump. There is also a USB to WART module connected, which allows us to view detailed log output on the serial console for debugging. We will continue working with the same project from the previous video, starting exactly where we left off. Here, I have already loaded both projects in STM32 Cube IDE. Let's start by opening and working with the bootloader project first. The first thing we need to add is a CRC32 implementation. This function will be used by the bootloader to calculate the checksum of the application that is stored in flash memory. On the PC side, we also generate CRC for the same application binary file. This CRC value is then written into the application header at build time, so it becomes part of the firmware image. At runtime, the bootloader recalculates the CRC over the entire application image, and compares it with the CRC value stored in the header. If both values match, the application is considered valid and safe to execute. Although STM32 provides a hardware CRC unit, its default configuration does not match the standard CRC32 algorithm that is commonly used on the PC side. Because of this mismatch, the CRC values would not be the same. For this reason, we deliberately use a software CRC32 implementation. This ensures that the checksum calculated on the PC and the checksum calculated by the bootloader always match exactly. So let's copy the CRC library files into our bootloader project. You can get these files by downloading the project from the link provided in the description of this video. Next, let's open the bljump.c file and include the crc32.h file at the top. Inside the application validity function, we are already performing two checks, one for the magic number and another one for the reset handler address. Now, let's add the checks for the application size and the CRC as well. First, the bootloader checks the application size. The size should not be zero, and it also must not be greater than maximum application size. We need to define this maximum application size value in the flash layout file. For the configuration I am using here, the maximum allowed application size will be 47 kilobytes. As I mentioned earlier, the flashlayout.h file will remain the same for both the bootloader and the application. So let's define this application size in the application flash layout as well. We will not actually use this value in the application code, but defining it there helps keep both flash layout files identical. If this size check fails, the bootloader will return error 3. Now comes the CRC check. The bootloader will calculate the CRC starting from the start of the application address. The size of the application is already stored in the size element of the application header structure, so we can use that value directly. After calculating the CRC, the bootloader will compare it with the CRC element stored in the application header structure. If there is any mismatch between these two values, the function will return error 4. If all the checks are passed successfully, the function will return 0, indicating that the application is valid. Let's continue with the bootloader main file now. We are already checking the application validity in this file, so we do not need to modify anything major here. However, I am going to add a little more detailed error checking. Here, I am implementing different log messages for different error codes returned by the validity function. After printing the error message, the red LED will blink in an infinite loop to indicate a failure. If no error is returned by the function, the bootloader will make the jump to the application, just like before. Now let's build the bootloader project. It builds without any errors, so let's move on to the application project next. Inside the application main file, we have already created a dedicated section for the application header structure. Inside this structure, we will store important information such as the application size and the CRC value. But before we can store these values, we first need to calculate both the size and the CRC of the application. For this, I am going to use a Python script, which will calculate and output both of these parameters for us. Let's first copy this script into the project folder. This script requires a binary file as input, and for this project, we already have the application binary file available. However, if you remember from the previous video, this binary file also contains the data for the application header section. Because of this, we should not use this binary file to generate the application CRC. If you check the size of this file, you can see that it is 7204 bytes in total. Whereas the application size shown by STM32Cube IDE is only 6.04 kilobytes. So the binary file is showing roughly 1 kilobyte more than the actual application size, and this extra space is due to the 1 kilobyte application header. Since the header section is defined in the application flash linker script, it is also included in the generated application binary file. As I mentioned in the previous video as well, we need to generate a new binary file that does not include the application header section. We need to do this using a post build command. I will include this command in the project folder, which you can download using the link provided in the description of this video. Let's copy this command first. Now open the project properties, go to C++ build, then settings, and open the build steps section. Enter the copied command into the post build steps field. This command generates a new binary file by removing the application header section, leaving only the actual application image. The removed header corresponds exactly to the header region we defined earlier in the application flash layout. Next, enter the name of the ELF file that needs to be processed, and finally specify the name of the binary file that will be generated after the build completes. Save this configuration and build the project again. You can now see that a new application binary file has been generated. Let's open the application project and browse inside the debug folder. Here is the new application binary file, and its size is now 6180 bytes. This confirms that the application header section has been removed from the binary file. Now we can safely generate the CRC for this new binary file. Open the CRC script in a text editor and provide the correct binary file name in the script. Save the script and then run it. You need to have Python installed on your system in order to run this script. Once the script runs, you can see the application size and the application CRC printed as output. Now copy these values from here and enter them into the application header section, so that the bootloader can read and use them. Let's build the application project again. Since we have edited only the header section, and this section is not included in the CRC calculation, the CRC value of the application remains unchanged. We can confirm this by running the script again. You can see that there is no change in either the application size or the CRC value. At this point, we now have both the application and the bootloader files ready to be flashed. So open STM32 Cube Programmer and connect the SD link. Go to the download section and flash both files one by one. You can flash the new application binary file at the application address, but I will use the ELF file instead, since I do not want to manually enter the addresses. I am also flashing the ELF file for the bootloader project. Alright, both files have been flashed successfully, so let's test the setup now. Open the serial monitor so we can view the log messages. I am going to reset the board now. You can see that the green LED is blinking, which means the application is running correctly. As shown in the logs, the bootloader is able to jump to the application. This confirms that the bootloader successfully verified both the application size and the CRC. Now let's connect the SD link to STM32 Cube Programmer again. Next, read the application header, which is located at an offset of 4000. Here you can see the header data, which consists of the magic number, followed by the application size, and then the CRC value. Just to make sure this process is working correctly, I am going to manually change the application CRC. Here, I am modifying one byte of the CRC value. Now, when the bootloader calculates the application CRC, it will not match with the CRC stored in the application header. As a result, the bootloader will treat this as an invalid application and will skip the jump. Let's flash the application project again, and reboot the board. You can see that the red LED is blinking, which indicates that the bootloader is not able to jump to the application. The log messages show the same behavior, confirming that the bootloader failed to jump due to a CRC error. So this is how the bootloader verifies the CRC of the application before jumping into it. The same concept is also applied during the OT update process. In an OT update, the application header is used as metadata that describes the firmware image, such as its size and CRC. Before flashing anything into the internal memory, the bootloader first validates the OTIA image by calculating its CRC and comparing it with the expected value. Only if this check passes does the bootloader proceed to flash the application. After the flashing process is complete, the bootloader calculates the CRC once again to make sure the application was written correctly and is safe to run. That is it for this video. In the next part of this series, we will implement the OTIA flag. The bootloader will check this flag, and if the flag is set, it will decide to flash the OTIA image. Otherwise, it will directly jump to the application. That's all for today. You can download the complete project using the link provided in the description of this video. Leave a comment if you have any doubts or questions. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.